These works I cut up thoroughly with a curry comb, and then, throwing the shreds into a sieve, shifted out carefully all that might be thought decent, a mere trifle, reserving the hard phrases, which I threw into a large tin pepper caster with longitudinal holes, so that an entire sentence could get through without material injury. The mixture was then ready to use. When called upon to play Thomas Hawk, I anointed a sheet of foolscap with the white of a gander's egg, then shredding the thing to be reviewed as I had previously shredded the books, only with more care so as to get every word separate, I threw the latter shreds in with the former, screwed on the lid of the caster, gave it a shake, and so dusted out the mixture upon the egged foolscap, where it stuck. The effect was beautiful to behold. It was captivating. Indeed, the reviews I brought to pass by this simple expedient have never been approached, and were the wonder of the world. At first, through bashfulness, the result of inexperience, I was a little put out by a certain inconsistency, a certain air of the bizarre, as we say in France, worn by the composition as a whole. All the phrases did not fit, as we say in the Anglo-Saxon. Many were quite awry. Some even were upside down, and there were none of them which were not in some measure injured in regard to effect by this latter species of accident when it occurred, with the exception of Mr. Lewis Clark's paragraphs, which were so vigorous and altogether stout that they seemed not particularly disconcerted by any extreme of position, but looked equally happy and satisfactory whether on their heads or on their heels. What became of the editor of the Gadfly after the publication of my criticism on his Oil of Bob is somewhat difficult to determine. The most reasonable conclusion is that he wept himself to death. At all events, he disappeared instantaneously from the face of the earth, and no man has seen even the ghost of him since. This matter having been properly accomplished, and the furies appeased, I grew at once into high favor with Mr. Crabbe. He took me into his confidence, gave me a permanent situation as Thomas Hawk of the Lollipop, and, as for the present he could afford me no salary, allowed me to profit, at discretion, by his advice. "My dear Thingham," said he to me one day after dinner, "I respect your abilities and love you as a son. You shall be my heir. When I die I will bequeath you the Lollipop. In the meantime, I will make a man of you. I will, provided always that you follow my counsel. The first thing to do is to get rid of the old boar." "Boar?" said I inquiringly. "Pig, eh? Oper, as we say in Latin." "Who? Where?" "Your father," said he.